Here we will explain you about PEEP. PEEP stands for positive end expiratory pressure. Normally when we breathe, after exhalation, the pressure inside the lungs is at zero atmospheric reference. By the application of PEEP, we actually provide positive pressure even at the end of expiration. That keeps the lung distended. How does that help? It helps in the correction of pulmonary edema. We know in both cardiogenic and non-cardiogenic pulmonary edema, the alveoli are flooded with fluid, the interstitium is flooded with fluid and infiltrates, and when the alveoli are flooded, they cannot participate in the gas exchange process. We want them to be open, to be patent, to participate in this gas exchange. That is how they help. The other thing which the PEEP helps, or the positive pressure helps, especially in heart failure of cardiogenic origin, is that it increases the intrathoracic pressure. This increased intrathoracic pressures improve the LV contractility, it decreases the afterload, and may improve the cardiac function. In ARDS, it improves oxygenation, that is by involving more alveoli in the gas exchange process. It may prevent alveolar damage. Now we know if the alveoli are collapsed, a lot of pressure will be required only to open them, and further pressure will be required to fill them up with air for gas exchange. Now this causes a huge excursion of pressure with each breath. We know that larger excursions of alveolar pressure causes more injury to the alveolar walls. We call it the shear injury. This can be reduced by the application of PEEP. It may improve compliance. Compliance is improved because the distension of these collapsed alveoli now put them at a mechanical advantage. This can be seen by looking at the pressure volume curve, where we see that the initial pressures produce very little change in volume, and then there is a point at which a small change in pressure produces large change in volume. We call it the lower inflection point, and it is best discerned when we actually look at the pressure volume graph on a ventilator in real time. That lower inflection point can help us in setting up of the optimal PEEP. Traditionally, the PEEP setting is titrated to the FiO2 according to an algorithm, which is present with the ARDSnet trial, the largest trial on ARDS patient. And here, the PEEP is set from 5 to 24 for an FiO2 from 21 to 100%. So, according to the FiO2 needs, you may put a PEEP pressure. Otherwise, you can keep titrating the PEEP to look at a point where the lung compliance is the best, the oxygenation is the best, and the pressures are the least. Recruitment maneuver is one thing which is worth talking about. It is also application of PEEP, but very high PEEP for a very transient period. Generally around 40 centimeters of PEEP for 40 seconds. We apply it continuously, and then after a few minutes or few seconds, we look at improvements in both oxygenation and compliance. The only problem with such high application of PEEP is that there could be trauma due to the pressures, or the increase in intrathoracic pressures can be too much, which can lead to reduced venous return and hypotension. When you do a recruitment maneuver, it is best to keep the patient paralyzed, because if they cough with such high pressures, then they can cause lung injury. Anyway, whenever we apply high PEEP, we would like to keep the patients well sedated, so that coughing and all do not occur. And because high PEEPs may be a little uncomfortable to the patient, the higher sedation levels may actually facilitate mechanical ventilation. So you can start with a high PEEP, come down, or you may start with a lower PEEP and up titrate, and reach a point where you feel optimal PEEP has been applied. Once you try to take the patient off the ventilator, you are having improvement in the lung function. How do you down titrate the PEEP? Well, the first thing you do is cut down on the FiO2, and only after the FiO2 comes below 60%, then you down titrate the PEEP, and it should be done slowly in ARDS. Maybe a 1 cm water pressure decrease or 2 every 6 hours. That is how slow you can go. The major problem actually the pressure applied, and we will look at that. The pressures which are producing so much benefit also causes complications. Once we exceed a plateau pressure of 30, the incidence of lung injury decreases significantly. Suppose we apply a PEEP of 20, then we have an option of only having 10 cm more of additional pressure, but this may not be good for producing adequate volume of breath. But this is the bargain that we make, that we try to decrease the tidal volume. We start with tidal volumes of as much as 8 ml per kg body weight, come down to 6 ml per kg body weight, but if we are not able to manage the plateau pressures, we can come down to as much as 4 ml per kg body weight. Now when we come down on the volumes, the amount of minute ventilation available decreases, and this may cause accumulation of carbon dioxide. This is also called as permissive hypercapnia, and it should not let the patient go into severe acidosis. So you have a bargain between low volume, high PEEP, and controlled plateau pressures. How do you achieve that? One thing which has been found is lower tidal volumes may prevent injury as compared to higher tidal volumes. So we should always target maybe 6 ml or so, or maybe even lower. It may worsen compliance. Now, ARDS may have an inhomogeneous lung involvement. The certain areas of the lungs may actually have normal, near normal alveoli, and some areas may have very bad alveoli. But what happens is the PEEP gets distributed to all of them. It can overdistend the normal alveoli significantly, put them at a mechanical disadvantage, and it may not open some of the collapsed alveoli. So if you find the application of PEEP actually worsens compliance, that is where we know probably we are overdistending maybe some part of normal lung. And that overdistended normal lung, which had till now been participating well in gas exchange, may not do so. So the oxygenation may also get affected. It requires deep sedation, that's understood, because such high pressures and such distension of the chest wall and the lung would be very uncomfortable. Together with the higher respiratory rates, the lower tidal volumes, all of them is not physiological. The patients will be fighting ventilators if we do not sedate them well. We may even have to paralyze them. Now, there is a renewed interest in use of paralyzing agents in early ARDS, and probably it is from the point that it facilitates these extreme settings. So you may consider paralyzing them for 48 hours if need be, but that should not be a compulsory part. We may use paralyzing agents to facilitate ventilation, but we know that use of paralyzing agents does cause muscle weakness, so they should be used judiciously. Hypotension, because the intrathoracic pressure increases significantly, the venous return decreases, and the patients can have hypotension. So always when you ventilate these patients, at least in the initial few hours, be very cautious about this hypotension, which occurs due to, you can call, relative hypovolemia, and you may require some amount of fluid to fill them up. But we also know that fluid therapy in ARDS may cause worsening of the lung function. So the balance has to be very good. How do we manage PEEP, decrease the complications? One is keep the patient absolutely sedated, and more importantly, not let them cough. Because if they cough, there could be a pneumothorax, there could be significant rise in airway pressures. Dyssynchrony, obviously when they are fighting the ventilator, with such tidal volumes where cycling and triggering takes place erratically, the mechanical ventilation will go haywire. So make sure that the machine and the ventilator work in synchrony. Sedate them deep. Normally we may bargain for a RAS score of maybe -3, but these are patients where we may need -4 or -5, and obviously if we paralyze them, we have to keep them at a RAS score of -5. Adequate volume status, as I said, to prevent this intrathoracic pressure related hypotension. Most importantly, no suction, or maybe minimal suction. Suctioning is a stimulus for cough. suctioning is a negative pressure phenomena, whereas mechanical ventilation is positive pressure. So when you do suctioning, there is likelihood of loss of PEEP, loss of some amount of tidal volume, and even oxygenation, which even for a small period of time could be very detrimental in those with ARDS. And it serves no value. It should only be done if you see there are copious secretions which are obstructing the tubes, which are impairing mechanical ventilation. Only then you should suction. The other problem is also with nebulization. Bronchodilator, these nebulized drugs have no role, but we may have to use some nebulized antibiotics. As far as possible, try to decrease nebulization, because they have problems which are similar to suctioning: loss of ventilation, loss of FiO2, loss of PEEP, and also may be a portal for introduction of infection. These patients are already candidates who may have higher risk of infections. Down titrate fast, maybe. Okay, once you have achieved your targets, you've cut down on the FiO2, now think of down titrating the PEEP. And as I said, we down titrate, but we do it slow because we don't want the lungs to become de-recruited fast. But try to see that we are able to keep our patients on minimal PEEP with maximum benefit when we come down. If we can control these pressures well, then maybe we achieve success.